Yeah. Yeah. Huh?
That's right, punk! Quit it! Hey!
Thanks, man. Thanks.
I'm home. Oh, welcome back. There was a letter in the mailbox for you. A friend? Oh, my show is almost done.
I'll protect you all from the madness of this world. I'll take you to a place where you can be at peace. Yes, it's much more peaceful than here.
Don't rescue anymore. Is this a warning?
No punctuation or capitalization. Aw, what a cliche.
Ain't this just a prank? The kind of stuff that only happens in the movies?
Did you show this to your uncle?
Senpai, Dojima-san is trustworthy. But it may be best to keep this to ourselves. He will ask why you received such a letter, and if he were to put you under surveillance, our hands would be tied. If this letter is real, what's most important isn't what it says. It's the fact that it was delivered to the Dojima residence, addressed directly to you. This means the culprit knows in great detail who has been interfering with his crimes. And of all of us, he chose to deliver his message to the Dojima residence, home of a police detective. I'd have this letter checked at a crime lab if I could, but even then I doubt they'd find anything. The text is a warning, while the subtext expresses the culprit's confidence that we can't use it to pinpoint his identity.
So it's useless to tell the police. In fact, that would make things worse.
Cross your fingers, it's just a prank.
I think the chances of that are slim. This message is too specific, too perfect to be a prank. How could the killer know so much about us? Could he be watching us from somewhere?
Teddy's been saying for a while that when we're over there, he senses someone watching us. Wait. Every time we went to the other side to rescue someone, did we end up on the Midnight Channel ourselves?
I don't know. It seems like no one else knows what we're doing. I haven't heard any rumors about us at school. Even the people who I know check that channel haven't said anything. The only gossip I heard was about the people who disappeared.
I see. Come to think of it, how the Midnight Channel works is still a mystery.
Let's put aside for now the matter of what that world truly is. There's too little data to go on. For now, we need to keep in mind that the culprit knows who we are. As long as we're all aware of that, it will be enough for now.
Yeah, guess there's no use thinking about stuff we can't understand. Freaking out over speculation is just what the killer wants us to do, right?
Yeah. All right, mind if I change the subject then? The culture festival's just around the corner. What's our class doing again?
Oh yeah, it hasn't been decided yet, huh?
I heard we'll be voting on it soon. But aren't they still gathering ideas?
Whoa, I think Yosuke just got hit with a bolt of inspiration. Whatever it is, it'll be out there. I'd bet my lunch on it.
Hey, Senpai. Have you decided who you'll be going around the campus with during the festival? My schedule's still wide open, you lucky guy.
Oh, she just had to say something.
You're late.
Hurry, let's go. I don't get it. Let's go. This.
Oh. What is this? Bye.
Oh, welcome home, Big Bro.
Well, as you all know, next week is the Culture Festival. And as you also know, we still haven't decided what our class is going to do for it. You guys don't care, do you?
We are going to decide based on the suggestions we have so far. Please vote for one of them. Here they are. Break area, video room, and study room.
Wow. Sounds like whatever we pick, we don't need to put any effort into it. Talk about lack of motivation.
Yeah, but the easier the better, right?
Oh, one more. Group date cafe.
Hey, who put in a suggestion like that? Was it you, Chie?
Yeah, right. Why would I do such a thing?
What's a group date cafe?
Who knows? But I doubt anyone will vote for it. Our class is actually a pretty serious bunch.
Yeah, it's just a joke idea. You gotta have one weird one mixed in, you know?
Ah, figures!
We'll be passing around the vote sheet. Just circle one of the suggestions.
All right, time to count the votes. The first vote is group date cafe. Second vote, group date cafe. Huh? Seriously? Third vote, video room. Fourth vote, group date cafe. Group date cafe, study room,
Group Date Cafe.
Well, first place? What are we gonna do?
Don't ask me! This is your fault! I do wonder, though, do all those people who voted for it realize they have to run it themselves?
I've never been on a group date before, so I was a little curious.
What the? You voted for it?
Yeah. I thought it would be sad if no one voted for it.
But Yosuke's the one behind it!
Hey, it wasn't just me. It came in first place. The public agrees.
Well, since the majority rules, we'll be doing the group date cafe. But what does that even mean? Is it like speed dating? Can we really pull this off? You'd all better pitch in on this.
Actually, would the teachers be okay with this?
Dude, how could Kashiwagi say no?
Miss Kashiwagi's busy getting ready for those two notorious pageants. That's why she's leaving it up to us students to decide what to do.
Yeah, right. She just dumped it in our laps because she didn't want to bother.
Group date cafe? Are we gonna get any customers with this?
Seriously, what is a group date cafe? I voted for it and I didn't even know.
Oh my gosh. How the heck's this gonna turn out?
Yeah. Yeah.
The other day, I went to visit Dad's grave. It's the first time I went on my own. I had a lot to tell him. How was it? Well, I felt like I could finally face him. A little late, though. Dad told me something right before he died. If you're a man, you have to become strong. Felt like he was telling me I wasn't a real man. Pissed me off. So I changed my looks and pushed myself away from people. Fighting gangs, thinking I was protecting Mom, trying to catch this killer. I thought all that was how I was becoming strong. That I was really making up for all the trouble I caused. I was drunk off my power. But that wasn't it. That ain't what Dad meant. I still don't really get what being strong means, but I'm gonna start by not lying to myself. No more being scared of everyone, hiding my hobbies, staying away from people.
Anytime, any place, I'm gonna bust right through as my own self.
that's the way to deal with that other me in the TV world. As long as there's someone like that snot-nosed kid to accept me, I ain't afraid of nothing. Sir, it's all thanks to you. Oh yeah, I'm gonna put those dolls of mine up for sale at the shop. They were a big hit with that kid and his mom. They called me just to say thank you. I got a kick out of that. Oh, I gotta go buy supplies. I need a jet.
Welcome back.
Hello. I apologize. Shall we go home now?
Welcome home!
Good morning.
Yo!
It's quite all right. Excuse me.
Huh? Huh?
Good day. Yes. Yes. I'll see you again.
You're back.
This. Mister.
Mister, thank you.
Hey.
Thank you.
Senpai!
That...
Good day. Sorry. Let's split.
Welcome back.
Yo!
Forget what they want.
On top of planning it, Kashiwagi's gonna be in it?
So that's why she agreed to plan this event.
A lot of signups here. I'm surprised so many people took an interest.
Whoa, Risei Kujikawa? Seriously?
Oh man, trust a celebrity to kill the fun of it all.
I bet she'll draw a huge crowd.
Wow, Yukiko-san's finally entering. If this was any other year, she'd win for sure. Now she's up against Rosette. It's gonna be a culture festival to remember.
Huh? Rosette's entering? She's gonna take part in something like this? Maybe I better think more seriously about saving a seat.
Look, Chie's entering too. She's actually pretty close to my type.
Actually, I hear she has a lot of secret admirers.
Naoto's that boyish, girlish, whatever, right? You know, she's, pretty cute.
Dude, you sound like a pervo when you laugh like that. But, to be honest, I think she's cute, too.
Yo, are you free for lunch? I don't know why, but Chie asked us to come to the roof. She looked pretty serious. I wonder if something's happened. Oh, and Kanji's coming, too.
Just say no, right? Like it was just a joke.
We wouldn't be so pissed if we could do that! With Kashiwagi planning this year's event, even those who got entered by other people can't back out!
Seriously? Must have been something in the fine print I overlooked.
So it was you!
Oh, crap!
Hey, do you want us to take part in the beauty pageant?
Well, yeah. I mean, you guys know how popular Yukiko is here. And on top of that, we have an idol and a detective prince. What's the point of having a beauty pageant if all these incredible heroines aren't going to take part?
So where do I fit in? Well, excuse me for not fitting in!
Hey, you want them to be in it too, don't you, Kanji?
Huh? I ain't interested in that stuff.
Naoto-kun, Kanji-kun says that he really wants you to be in it.
What? I didn't say nothing.
What about you? You want them to be in it, right?
I thought you might be a little jealous, not wanting me to show off to other guys, but I guess you're not that uptight.
Hey, you guys are inching onto the bandwagon with Yosuke, aren't you?
So long as there are people looking forward to seeing me, I might as well put on a show for them. Of course, there's no need to involve my agency in this.
That's right! That's the way to go! Teddy's looking forward to it too. Actually, I think he was more excited than anyone. It was him who was pushing me to sign you all up!
So Ted's behind this too!
We're in an awkward position. If we can't refuse, I suppose there's no sense in arguing the point. But it seems ill-fitting for someone like me to get up on stage. I wonder if there's any way I could take it up with the school authorities.
I don't think it's a problem at all. I mean, just do it, you know? Seriously.
Dude, looks like your blood's boiling even more than usual.
Silly Kanji, just tell her you want to see her on the stage. So, is it a deal? The four of us will be in the beauty pageant?
What are you saying?
I beg you, please be in it. If you do, my, doubts will finally be cleared. Come on! Make me a man!
Doubts? What are you talking about?
Look, just do it, damn it! I mean, you're an ace detective, aren't you?
What does that have to do with a beauty pageant?
We're back! I'm so tired.
Where'd you guys go?
Over to Jeunesse. We had to go get some paint and cloth.
Oh, for the decorations.
Thank you. Did you have them write you an invoice?
Yeah, I think they understood what it was for, so they wrote it without us having to ask.
There's some things I want to go over about the day of the event.
Is this about the group date cafe?
Yes, since Yosuke's leading the executive committee.
Wait, what?
It was your proposal, right?
Are you serious?
Well, all you have to do is the reception. After people sign in, have a few guys and girls sit facing each other at a table, conduct a short session first where they ask each other questions. After about half an hour of that, it'll be confession time. Get them to select the number of the person they like. If the other person accepts, that makes them a couple. Hey, Yosuke, you listening?
Yeah, I hear ya.
Stop it! Hey, if we roll up this bit of cloth, won't it kind of be like a ball? Yeah, okay, I'll be the catcher.
Why the catcher?
Hey, Yosuke, wanna be the batter?
I don't give a damn anymore. I'm in. Watch me slam that ball right back into your face.
Hey, you guys better get serious about this.
You're back.
Hey. I'm sorry. Go home!
Hey, it's Yosuke. We're expecting great things from you.
They're doing the cross-dressing pageant again this year? Man, they never learn, do they? Ooh, some people have signed up already. Man, what idiots would want to be in this thing? Let's see, Yosuke Hanamura...
Me?!
Wait, and Kanji Tatsumi? You're on here, too!
Wow, there's a lot of contestants. Didn't we only get, like, 2 people last year?
I heard this year, even if someone else signs you up, you can't back out.
Well, that's not cool. Hey, but what if they did sign themselves up?
Ew, what a disturbing thought! Seriously, that's really wrong.
Someone else signs you up? It's them. They must have done this. Damn good explanation for this.
For what?
For what, my ass? For signing us all up in the cross-dressing pageant. It was you, wasn't it?
Oh, that thing! Risei-chan started saying, let's all have fun with this, so I didn't really have a choice. And Kashiwagi seems happy too now that there's more people involved in it.
You little... This is cross-dressing! Cross-dressing!
Well, you're the one who started it! It's because of you that we can't back out of the beauty pageant, so it serves you right!
That's beside the point.
Don't worry. We'll make you absolutely enchanting, okay?
That's not what's important here.
It's about a man's pride, dammit!
Whoa. Are you serious?
Yeah, this has nothing to do with pride or any of that. You know already, right? Once someone signs you up, you can't back out. If you got a problem with that, go talk to Ms. Kashiwagi.
There's no way she's gonna listen.
Why are you giving up? I ain't doing this. Period.
Kanji-kun, are you still okay as far as the mandatory attendance policy? I don't think it would be wise to disappoint a teacher too much.
You are a scary gal. You know that, Senpai?
Just leave it to us to dress you guys up. Risei-chan's with us too. There's no way you won't turn out pretty.
You're positive we'll be pretty?
I guarantee it.
Hey, why are you suddenly fine with this?
Well, if we gotta do this, might as well go all the way with it.
There's nothing manly about being a woman. I seriously refuse.
Kashiwagi's sure gonna get angry if you don't show up. Maybe you and Kanji-kun can be classmates next year.
Why is this happening? We all end up in the same boat without our consent. What kind of joke is this?
The exact same joke you pulled on us?
If we gotta do this, might as well go all the way with it.
Oh, welcome home, big bro.
Come in for a first-hand experience with group dating.
Oh, this is so embarrassing. There's not that many people passing by here in the first place.
I think we need some shills to drum up interest.
Shills? Who?
Who else is here besides us?
Isn't that kind of sad?
Do we have a choice? We need customers to get the ball rolling. If there aren't many people passing by, we have to get the attention of the ones who are by any means necessary.
But there's only five of us here.
Yo, how's it going? I came to check up on you... guys?
Perfect timing!
But now we've got four guys and two girls.
Eh, you guys are cross-dressing tomorrow anyways. One of you can sit on the girls' side.
What? I'm not gonna...
Oh, you're volunteering?
You never run out of surprises, man.
Well, let's get started. You guys can start now. Will someone please start?
He's really getting into this.
Actually, what the hell is this?
A mock group date?
Should I lead off? I guess I'd like a cute girl.
Well, for me, I guess a girl that's kind and sort of fragile, you know? Someone I'd want to protect. Man, this is, yeah... Hey, your turn, Kanji.
I guess someone who's kind of mysterious and looks strong, but's actually kind of...
Yeah, I really wonder who you're talking about.
Okay, out of the three of us here, who would you date?
Hey, I object to this line of questioning.
Oh, don't worry. All right, let's start with you, Chie-san.
Huh? Wait, well?
Me? Who would I choose to date? Well, that's private.
Isn't it?
Okay, your turn. Who would you want to date?
Phew, what a relief.
Oh.
Senpai, how are you doing?
Market. The group date cafe is officially a failure.
Welcome back.
Why are you guys just standing there? Come on, hurry up and sit down!
Come on, Kanji-kun! Over here!
Don't worry. I won't hurt you.
What about me? It turns out I'm entering this, too. I must win this contest to see my dream realized.
He seemed bored, so we signed him up as a last-minute contestant.
So you're making him suffer, too, huh? Well, if he's been signed up, there's nothing we can do about it. Naoto-kun, can you lend us a hand? We'll leave Teddy to you.
Me?
The Naoto-Teddy team's unstoppable!
Well then,
First, I need some dazzling makeup.
You're right. Then I'll go borrow a makeup kit from someone.
Wait! The battle begins by choosing the right equipment!
We gotta use fake eyelashes, right?
Yeah, bring it on!
So it begins.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now begin the second day of the Culture Festival with the ever-popular Miss Yasogami Pageant. Let's get right down to it and introduce our first contestant. She's a runaway express train who's Inaba born and bred and can kill with both her fists and her looks! Presenting Kanji-chan of the first year Class 3!
Sup?
This is wrong on every level.
Now, don't rip me apart for asking, but what would you say is your best feature?
My eyes?
Whoa! A conventional answer from this all too unconventional beauty! After such a strong start, I don't know how much of a chance the others have, but here's our second contestant! An eloquent heiress of the noble Juness, she's pure disappointment from the moment she opens her mouth. Presenting Yosuke-chan of the second year Class 2!
And here I thought Yosuke-senpai would be able to pull it off.
Dude, it's terrifying. I can just imagine someone like him sitting across from me on a train.
Now, you look ready to win in that outfit. Do you often dress like this?
Hell no! Like, no way!
Who is with this? The laughing stock's up here.
What did you think this was about?
I've already had about enough of this, but there's still more to come! Up next, our third contestant! She has the mildly bitter tang of the city, and she's made more girls cry than there are stars in the sky. Presenting our transfer student who's been breaking hearts in the second year, Class 2!
Amor! Senpai, why are you doing this?
Whoa, I thought he was cooler than that.
Sounds like your entrance is causing quite a stir. Did you sign yourself up?
Wow, he was more gung-ho about this than Kanji. Damn that Kashiwagi. How dare she tear away our innocence like this? Now I'm scarred for life, damn it!
Our last contestant is a random, unaffiliated entrant. She's a friend of our other beauties. Calling herself King of the TV World, she's a cute, sexy little number. Give a warm welcome to Teddy-chan!
Give me your heart!
That's a boy? He's so cute!
I'd hit it.
Miss Yasugami Pageant is... the random contestant who won everyone's heart, Miss Teddy! As our champion, Miss Teddy will receive a very special prize. Later this afternoon, we will be hosting the Miss Yasugami Pageant with actual beauties this time! Your reward is a position as an honorary judge in that pageant!
Woohoo!
An honorary judge? That's one lame prize for what you gotta go through.
Not everyone can get that excited over a judge position.
Seeing him so happy kind of makes me happy too.
Yeah, he's like over the top innocent.
Well then, Miss Teddy, how does it feel to have won the pageant and become a judge?
The long-awaited day has finally come! I decree that one of the judging criteria later this afternoon will be... ta-da! A swimsuit competition!
What the hell? Over my dead body!
I didn't bring a swimsuit.
That bear needs to be disappeared. Well, I doubt he has the authority to declare that unilaterally.
This is great. I love the direction this is going.
Dress yourselves up as well as you can, you little brats.
What is she, the rival woman on a soap opera? Wait, is Kashiwagi serious about winning this?
Mr. Teddy dropped this off. He said that they're swimsuits.
My mature charms will win the day. I brought my own swimsuit, of course.
I brought my own, too. What's with these people?
Hey, let's not do this.
What's that? Getting cold feet? Wise of you to back out of a fight you can't win. You call yourself an idol, but you're just jailbait with no brains, no guts, and especially no figure.
What? There's no way their type would be crowned Miss Inaba. Why not just let them back out?
Oh, and I suppose you think you're gonna take the crown, you little snoring pig!
Snoring? What are you talking about? Your face is as foul as your mouth, and your brain's as rotten to boot.
We went through hell because of you! That's it! Now I'm pissed!
Oh, you're going to challenge me? It's useless. Don't waste your energy. Let this be a warning to the others, too. Ugh. You're going to lose. Now's your last chance to run away.
Run away? Why the hell would we run from someone like you?
Well, we did kind of run away last time.
That's what I'm saying! We gotta stand our ground and get our revenge for that! How can we cower and hide when they're picking a fight?
Yeah.
Right, Risa-chan! Now, Jokun! We won't run from this, right?
Huh? Me too?
Why are you letting yourself be so easily provoked?
There's no way! Absolutely no way that I'm wearing a swimsuit.
You're not going anywhere.
But that's not all for the Culture Festival's main event. There's still more to come in the Miss Yasukami pageant. The judging continues. Can you hear the crowd going wild? Now for our next contestant, Miss Chie Satanaka of the second year's Class 2. Come on out, Chie.
I'm kind of shy and reserved, and my favorite food is pudding.
That liar. It's steak.
Thank you very much. Up next, another contestant from Class 2, Miss Yukiko Amagi!
My name is Yukiko Amagi. My family runs the Amagi Inn. If you ever find yourself in the area, please give us a visit. Our hot springs are open to the public year-round, so whenever you're in the mood to enjoy them, please drop by.
All right, that'll do nicely. Next up, a very familiar face from the first year Class 2, Miss Rise Kujikawa!
Hi, hi! My name's Rise Kujikawa! I haven't been in town very long, but it's a great place, and I'm 100% thrilled to be here! So sorry that I'm not working as an idol right now. Rosette's gonna do her best, so I hope you'll all cheer for me.
The real Rosette, ladies and gentlemen, in the flesh! Oh, thank you very much. Next is the mysterious transfer student of the first year's Class 1, Miss Noto Shirogane!
Hey, Kanji.
Here she comes.
Hey, shh. Pipe down.
I'm Naoto Shiragane. It's hard to believe I'm up on a stage at a pageant like this. This is beyond my wildest imaginings. I really don't know what to say. Can I step back now?
And with that, all six uniquely beautiful contestants are on stage! Now, let's have our special judge, Mr. Teddy, ask them some questions.
I am Teddy, the honorary judge for this pageant. Please keep in mind that if you anger me, you will be at a disadvantage. Well, Miss Chie, do you have a boyfriend? Ms. Yukiko, have you ever smooched anyone before?
Huh? Stop it!
Ms. Naoto, where are you ticklish?
I beg your pardon?
Can I stay at your house next time, Risei-chan?
What kind of a question is that?
Anyways, I have a surprise announcement for you all! Wait till you hear this! For the first time ever, this year's pageant will feature a swimsuit competition! And it's all thanks to Mr. Teddy here! We'll take a brief break while our contestants put on their swimsuits and be back in just a few moments.
Sound like a dirty old man. Chie-senpai is cute, though.
I'm sorry.
Sorry for what? This is great!
Wow. Yukiko-senpai. She is exactly how I imagined she'd be.
Gorgeous.
Huh?
Huh? Miss Naoto? She's not coming out. Well, sad news, everyone, but Miss Naoto won't be coming out for this portion.
Fine by me. The fewer rivals I have to crush, the better.
Oh, well, I had a feeling that would happen. Too bad, Kanji.
Huh? Well, yeah. But don't you think it was brave of her to at least show up in the first round?
Yeah, you're right. Well, it's about time we voted. Who are you going for? A class act all the way. An idol's idol.
Thanks for waiting, everyone! The results are in! Looking at the way the vote went, you guys out in the audience had a hard time picking a favorite. Lots of different opinions, with every one of our contestants having their own enthusiastic supporters. On the other hand, it looks like you girls were all thinking the same thing. And so, there's a clear winner!
grand prize goes to Miss Noto Shirogane! Her androgynous charm seems to have won most of the girls' hearts. We'd like to present Miss Noto with her award now, but it looks like she stepped outside.
She won, even though she dropped out of the last part. That's pretty funny.
Man, losing to Naoto. Well, I guess I didn't appeal to the girls that much. Oh well, I think it's enough that we beat those two hands down, Senpai.
How could I lose a beauty pageant?
Miss Kajiwaki, I can't believe this.
No, neither can I. Hanako.
Miss Kajiwaki.
Ah, good thing we found you. I've got to make a business trip to the prefectural office, and I won't be back until tomorrow. Shame it had to fall during your school's culture festival. Nanako and I were both looking forward to it. Sorry to dump this on you, but could you show Nanako around?
Would you like to walk around with us, Nanako-chan?
Can I?
Thanks. Then I'm gonna get going.
Trip.
Yeah. You have fun too, Nanako.
Okay, Dad.
Hey, Nanako-chan, why don't you come over and stay at my place tonight?
Huh? Huh? What did you just say, Yuki-chan?
Ooh, a celebration at your inn?
Is that okay with you?
Uh-huh. I promised you guys a while ago, so yeah.
Hell yeah! I'm down!
Can I boil eggs in the hot springs?
Oh, I should call my grandpa and let him know. It's just one night, right?
Come on, it'll be fun. Everyone will be there.
Can I? Let's go! I want to spend the night!
Hot springs, yukata, flushed skins.
Are you sure it's okay? I mean, isn't it still the busy season?
We've had fewer visitors this year. There are some open rooms, too.
Oh, okay. Might as well, then. Man, when was the last time I stayed at Yukiko's place?
Aw, we're in different rooms.
Well, duh.
It's one thing if they were next door, but they're so far away!
Yukiko said there weren't that many open rooms, so they're up on another floor. First thing they're gonna do is take Nanako-chan to the hot springs.
Is it one of those girls and guys together springs?
I don't want to take more than one bath if I don't have to. Why don't we take a dip before we hit the sack?
Yeah.
By the way, what's up with this room? It looks pretty expensive.
Oh, you thought so too. Normally a room like this wouldn't be open during the busy season. I was trying not to think about it, but you don't think something happened here, do you?
Senpai? What are you all quiet about?
Now that you mention it... Jeez, that freaked me out. You answer it, Kanji.
What are you freaking out for? Hello? Oh, I see. Cool, thanks. That was the front desk. Said the hot springs should be pretty empty right now.
Wow, Amagi Inn, great service. I broke out in a cold sweat.
Oh, come on then. Let's go wash it off.
I can't wait to take a bath with everyone. We'll all face the same way and wash each other's backs. And we're gonna sing songs while looking at Mount Fuji, right? Man, everything on this side is so fun. It's all thanks to you for bringing people over to my side. Thank you, Sensei.
Son?
Come on, just get inside.
Jeez.
Oh, I see. So, the truth comes out now, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
What's gotten into you all?
Come on over, there's plenty of room.
Huh? Oh. Okay.
Wow, Naoto, your skin looks so soft. Can I touch? Can I touch?
Huh? Wow, it really is smooth. You're so lucky. You have such fair skin and silky hair.
No unneeded body fat either.
Hey, where are you touching? Nanako-chan? Are you okay with staying over at someone else's place like this? Aren't you scared?
No, it's lots of fun. At home, I'm always alone until Big Bro comes back.
Oh, I see.
But I'm good at staying home alone. I always do what my dad tells me, like not opening the door for strangers.
Wow, I bet he's so proud of you.
Hey, Nanako-chan, do you want to swim around?
Can I?
I've been swimming here since I was young.
Do you still do it?
Huh?
Why are you hesitating?
Come on, let's race to the other side. Whoever loses owes everyone a fruit milk.
I want lemon soda.
What? Me too?
Check out my dead man's float! Wow! You're good!
Oh! What a giant spring! I'll show you all my teddy paddle!
Ow! What the... Huh? You guys!
Why are you guys here?
That's my line!
to punish them later.
Wow, you got him good.
My aim's pretty deadly, huh?
I wonder if they caught a glimpse.
Oh, it's actually the guy's turn to use the springs now.
I got the times mixed up.
Are you serious? Aw, crap! I think we went too far with them!
What should we do?
Oh, it'll be fine as long as we keep quiet about it. This'll just be between us girls.
Do you want to race again, Nanako-chan?
Damn it! I checked again, and sure enough, the hot spring's supposed to be for men at that hour.
They're so evil. Evil, I tell you!
I don't know why, but my head's all bumpy.
Those are lumps from the pails whacking you in the head. You got lumps, man.
Hey, guys, did you, see anything?
No.
None whatsoever.
Damn it. I lead a cursed life. Let's just go to bed.
Hold it, Senpai. Do you hear something?
What was that?
I heard it too.
Don't tell me. Is there one here?
One here? One what? Dude, what are you talking about?
This room. It's the one that announcer was staying in before she died. My mom was talking about it.
Oh God, you said it! I was trying to block it out and you had to go and say it! So that's why there's talismans here. Yukiko, that witch tempted us here knowing full well... Damn it! First the hot spring, now this. We've been completely suckered.
Oh, crap. There's no way I'm sleeping through this.
I've made up my mind. I'm going to Yuki-chan's room. I can't sleep soundly unless I'm watching everyone's sleeping faces as I drift off.
Sleeping faces? Are you gonna sneak into their room? You can't be... Hey, what should we do?
Damn, that was fast!
Dude, seriously, I can't stay here!
Alrighty! It'll be a surprise awakening for them! Good morning, everyone! It's a surprise awakening! No, a surprise break-in! This is Teddy, reporting in!
When did you put that on?
I feel awkward without it, so I always bring it!
Stop talking like that!
Oh, check it out, a hairbrush! And it's got long strands of hair on it!
You're really into this, aren't you?
Damn straight! It's time I got revenge for the campout.
Hey, good point. All right, I'll get my revenge too.
A toothbrush!
Holy crap, my heart's pounding. But what about Nanako-chan?
Don't worry, Nanako-chan is a magnanimous girl.
Well, that's true, but try not to wake her up. She's not part of our revenge scheme.
Oh! I finally reached the futons! They're fast asleep! Excuse me!
Yuki-chan! I'm scared of the ghosts!
All right. I can do this too. Time to prove I'm a man. Chie-senpai, be gentle!
Huh? One, two... Where's the rest of the futons?
What's going on?
Ugh. Sheesh. Ugh.
Oh, my! So that's how you guys are! You should have said so!
Such naughty boys!
Ah! Be gone!
Holy crap! Don't touch me!
We were crying our poor eyes out until now, you know. We thought there were no men who appreciated our beauty. All right, boys. I'm all yours. And not a word about this to anyone.
Come here, tiger.
This feels great. I love, love, love being able to take a bath anytime I want.
How's Nanako-chan?
Fast asleep.
Hey, did you know Miss Kashiwagi and Hanako-san were staying in the room next to ours? Those two seem to get along really well. I'm surprised.
They come and stay here now and again. Usually they come to cry when something breaks their hearts.
Huh. I guess they were really devastated from losing to Naoto-kun.
Please don't bring that up again.
Well, they do make a good team.